So, dear students, this is the third session of our chemistry bridge course. So, today we will learn something about acids, bases and salts. So, in your lower classes, you might have heard the word acids, bases and salts. So, what is an acid? So, an acid is a substance which is sour in taste and then turn blue litmus paper into red and then react with bases to form salts. An acid is a substance which is sour in taste. An acid is a substance which turns blue litmus paper into red. An acid is a substance which reacts with bases to form salts. What is the another definition of an acid? An acid is a substance which contain replaceable hydrogen atoms. Replaceable hydrogen atoms. So these are all the definitions of your high school classes. Example for acids, for example, hydrochloric acid. What is its formula? HCl. Nitric acid. Its formula? HNO3. Sulfuric acid, H2SO4, acetic acid, its formula CH3COOH. These are all some of the examples of acids. Say for example, tamarind unsendo is sour in taste. What is the acid present in it? It is tamaric acid. So citrus fruits, namely lemon, oranges, etc., contain citric acids, therefore they are sour in taste. Acetic acid, vinegar, is also an acid and it is also sour in taste. So all these are acids. Coming to litmus test, so you might have seen red litmus paper and blue litmus paper. Acids turn blue litmus paper into red. Since acid reacts with bases to form salt and water, say for example, HCl is an acid. It reacts with a base NaOH to give salt NaCl plus H2O. This is an acid and this is a base and this is salt and this one is water. So acid reacts with bases to give salt. This is another definition. So the another definition, acid is a substance which contain replaceable hydrogen atom. In these substances, when HCl is dissolved in water, it dissolves to give H++ Cl minus. This is replaceable hydrogen. Similarly, nitric acid dissociates to give H++ NO3 minus. It is a replaceable hydrogen. Similarly, H2SO4 gives 2H++ SO4 2-. So these two are replaceable hydrogen atoms. Similarly, acetic acid CH3COOH dissociates to give CH3COO minus plus H plus. So this is the replaceable hydrogen. Similarly, phosphoric acid H3PO4. So H3PO4 dissociates to give 3H plus plus PO4 3 minus. So these are replaceable hydrogen atoms. So an acid is a substance which contains replaceable hydrogen atoms. Replaceable hydrogen atoms. So this is the preliminary definitions of an acid. Coming to basicity of an acid. What is the meaning of basicity of an acid? Basicity of an acid. So in this acid, hydrochloric acid, how many replaceable hydrogens are there? It contains one replaceable hydrogen. It also contains one replaceable hydrogen. It contains two replaceable hydrogen. It contains one replaceable hydrogen, and this one contains three replaceable hydrogen. Therefore, the number of replaceable hydrogen atoms present in one molecule of an acid is called basicity of an acid. So what is basicity of an acid? The number of replaceable H atoms present in one molecule of an acid is called basicity of an acid. Basicity of an acid. Example: HCl, HNO3, CH3COOH. All these contains one replaceable hydrogen atoms. All contains one replaceable atom. They are called monobasic acids. Monobasic acids. So what is the basicity here? Basicity equals 1 in all these acids. Basicity name. What is the name of these acids? In all these acids, HCl, HNO3, acetic acid, etc., basicity equals 1 because they contain one replaceable hydrogen atoms. The name of these acids are called monobasic acids. Monobasic acids. Example 2, H2SO4, sulfuric acid. So here the number of replaceable hydrogen atom is 2. They are called dibasic acids. Similarly, H3PO4, number of replaceable hydrogen atom is 3. They are called tribasic acids. So this is the meaning of basicity of an acid. What is an acid? An acid is a substance which is sour in taste, turns blue litmus paper red, react with acids forming salts. And finally, an acid is a substance which contain replaceable hydrogen atoms. Depending upon the number of replaceable hydrogen atoms present in one molecule of an acid, they are called monobasic acids, dibasic acids, tribasic acids, etc. So examples for monobasic acids, dibasic acids, and these are tribasic acids. And then we will know what are strong acids and weak acids. Strong acids and weak acids. Strong acids and weak acids. So, what is a strong acid? An acid which easily gives hydrogen is called a strong acid. An acid which easily donates or gives the hydrogen is called a strong acid. An acid which easily donates the hydrogen atom is called strong acid. Is called strong acid. This is one definition. Number two, an acid which undergoes complete ionization in solution is called a strong acid. So example, HCl when dissolved in water it undergo complete ionization. HNO3 it also undergo complete ionization when dissolved in water. H2SO4 also undergo complete ionization when dissolved in water. Therefore, all these are the examples for strong acids. And then what are weak acids? The acid which does not give hydrogen atom or hydrogen ion easily are called weak acids. An acid which does not donate, the H atom easily is called a weak acid. And also an acid which undergo incomplete ionization. So in your incomplete ionization in solution are called weak acids. So example for weak acids, CH3COOH when dissolved in water it dissociates partially. CH3COO- + H+. So when they undergo incomplete ionization, what is the meaning of incomplete ionization? For example, if you add 100 molecules of hydrochloric acid into water, all the 100 molecules of hydrochloric acid dissociates to give 100 hydrogen ions and 100 chloride ions. Therefore, it is a strong acid. Similarly, HNO3, H2SO4. But in case of acetic acid, if you add 100 molecules of acetic acid in water, only 40 molecules dissociates to give acetate ions and hydrogen ions. therefore 40 by 100 is equal to 0.4. it is called degree of dissociation. So degree of dissociation in case of weak acid is less than 1. So degree of dissociation alpha is always less than 1 in case of weak acids. But in case of strong acids, degree of dissociation alpha is always equal to 1. So 100 out of 100 molecules, if 100 molecules undergo dissociation, 100 by 100 is equal to 1. So in case of weak acids, the degree of dissociation is always less than 1. So this is the differences between weak acids and strong acids. So these are all the preliminaries. We will go in detail the study of acids, bases and salts in your first PUC classes later on. And then coming to bases, so we will know what are bases. So bases are the substance which turn red litmus blue, and they react with acids forming salts. Next, bases are the substances which contain replaceable OH minus ions. So example, NaOH dissociates to give Na++ OH-. These OH minus ions are also called as hydroxyl ions. They are also called as hydroxide ions also. So KOH dissociates to give K++ OH-. CaOH twice gives Ca2+2OH-. AlOH thrice gives Al3+3OH-. So sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide contains only one OH group. They contain two OH groups, they contain three OH groups. So these are all the examples for bases. Coming to acidity of a base. So these are all the number of OH groups present. So number of OH groups. Here it is 1, here it is 1, here it is 2, and here it is 3. So these acids are called monoacidic acids. This is diacidic base. This is triacidic base. So this is the meaning of acidity of a base. What is acidity of a base? The number of replaceable hydroxyl groups present in one molecule of a base is called acidity of a base. What is the definition? The number of replaceable OH minus ions present in one molecule of a base is called acidity of a base. Acidity of a base, the number of replaceable OH minus ions present in one molecule of a base is called acidity of a base. So example, all these are examples. So monobasic acids, dibasic acids, tribasic acids, etc., depending upon the number of OH group present in one molecule of a base. So then coming to strong bases and weak bases. What is a strong base and what is a weak base? The base which undergo complete ionization in solutions are called strong bases. Bases which undergo incomplete ionization in aqueous solutions are called weak bases. And also, a base is said to be strong if it gives easily the OH minus ions, and a weak base is a base which does not give OH minus ions easily. If the base gives OH minus ions easily, they are called strong bases. If they do not give easily the OH minus ions, they are called weak bases. The base which gives OH minus ions easily is called a strong base. Example, NaOH, KOH, etc. NaOH, KOH, etc. are strong bases. Similarly, a strong base undergoes ionization. A strong base undergoes complete ionization in aqueous solution. Example, NaOH dissociate to give Na++, OH minus, KOH gives K++, OH minus. So in case of strong bases, the degree of dissociation alpha is always one. So this is about strong bases. Coming to the weak bases, the base which does not give the base which does not give OH minus ions easily. Easily are called, is called a weak base, is called a weak base. Example, ammonium hydroxide, calcium hydroxide, etc. are weak bases. Next, weak bases does not undergo, complete ionization in solution, So example, NH4OH does not undergo complete ionization, it gives NH4 plus plus OH minus. So here degree of dissociation alpha is always less than 1, So this is how we can differentiate between strong bases. Bases which contain OH minus ions are called bases. If they give easily OH minus ions are called strong bases. If they does not give OH minus ions are called weak bases. So in case of strong bases, the degree of dissociation is high and it is equal to 1. In case of weak bases, the degree of dissociation is less than 1. So this is about strong acids and strong bases. And lastly, we will learn what is known as a salt. What is a salt? Salts. When an acid reacts with a base, we will get salt, or salt is a substance when an acid reacts with a base. So when an acid reacts with a base, we get salt and water. So this reaction is called neutralization. For example, HCl when reacts with NaOH, you will get NaCl plus H2O. So this one is an acid, this is a base, this is salt, and this one is water. So this reaction is called neutralization. So similarly, when H2SO4 reacts with NaOH, so this is sulfuric acid and this one is sodium hydroxide, you will get Na2SO4 plus 2H2O. So this is water. What is this one is? This one is sodium sulfate. Sodium sulfate is a salt. Sodium chloride, it is a salt. All these are called salts. Then what is a salt? A salt is a substance. When an acid reacts with a base, we will get salt and water. So in a salt, there are two parts. Salt say for example NaCl. So here sodium carries positive charge and Cl minus negative charge. How it is obtained? When HCl reacts with NaOH, you will get NaCl plus H2O. So NaCl is a salt. It contains two ions. One is positive ion, another one is negative ion. Positive ion is called cation, negative ion is called anion. So cation is also called as basic radical. It is also called as basic radical. Basic radical. Anion is also called as acid radical. Why it is called basic radical? Na plus comes from the base, therefore it is called basic radical. Cl minus comes from acid, therefore it is called acid radical. So if you take any salt, it consists of two parts or two ions. One is cation, another one is anion. Positively charged ion is called cation, negatively charged ion is called anion. Cations are also called as basic radicals because this ion is obtained from a base, and anion are also called as acid radicals because they are obtained from an acid. Therefore, if you consider any salt, it contains two ions, namely acid radical and basic radical, or anions and cations. So during the analysis of a salt, so in your laboratory, a salt will be given and you will be asked to detect what are the acid radical, what are the basic radicals present in the salt. That is what is known as salt analysis. It is also called as qualitative analysis. So that we will discuss in detail in your regular practical classes. So this is enough for today. I will continue tomorrow.